Greetings, Eric Bakker, Naturopath. Thanks for coming back. I've been reading the news, like most people do, and I found this interesting report saying probiotics are useless. They may even be damaging your health. Stop taking them. I read this very interesting British article on some crappy, website, usually page two on these newspapers. They've got the ladies with the big boobs hanging out, these kind of newspapers where they slander people. And this news article basically said that all dietary supplements were pretty much useless. This reporter said that she's going to stop taking everything like selenium and everything because it was all junk, and science is proving now that everything's useless. So it's funny how everyone jumps on the bandwagon. They read something like this, that often will come out. We get these reports and then people start, saying, well, see, doesn't work for the majority and it's crap and science says this and science says that. Well, it was only 5 minutes ago where I was reading reports in the paper, that, for example, chromium, a supplement called chromium, could actually cause cancer in human beings. And when I had a very good look at the study, what they did with this dietary supplement, they were using chromium as a supplement on hamster cells in a laboratory, and they were injecting these hamster cells, I think it was ovarian cells from a hamster, they're injecting them with basically a solution that contained bleach and chromium. And they found that these cells started getting really sick and behaving weird. So then all these news reports came out, said that chromium causes cancer. And what they later on found, it was the bleach that they used in the solution along with the mineral chromium that caused a lot of problems. So it just shows you how science can get things horribly wrong. And next thing, the journalists hop on board for the ride and they make a whole, pig circus out of the whole thing. So I've just got this paper here I printed off where two studies just came out. And in one study, they gave people antibiotics before and after probiotics, for example. So antibiotics were given to people and they broke people up into a few different groups and they were experimenting with people, with probiotics to see what the outcome was. So and they found in one group of people, they had a good recolonization, but these bacteria that recolonized weren't necessarily the ones that were in their gut before the antibiotics. And in the other group, they gave people their own stool back, basically a bit like a fecal transplant. They gave them their own microbiome back, and they found that those people responded very rapidly and beautifully after the antibiotics. But it's not a feasible thing to do. Now, they're saying the group with the probiotics, people responded either well or horribly wrong when they received that. Well, my question is, why were these people even given antibiotics in the first place? Half of my time in the clinic is spent trying to clean up doctors' messes regarding antibiotics. And now we get these stupid, dumbass reports in the papers saying probiotics may even be harmful, and yet they never really talk about the antibiotics or the anti-life. So antibiosis is anti-life. So they go around killing life for so long, since the 40s and 50s when these drugs came out. And people like me try and restore life, and they still say it's not going to work, it's crap. The probiotics are no good, they're useless. Well, I can tell you guys that there are hundreds of scientifically published, credible studies that support probiotics. Even if you go to the Harvard website and the Mayo Clinic, they have to admit that probiotics do work. But here's the problem. Probiotics, A, are often a crap quality, because the probiotic... the problem with probiotics in the States a few years ago really shook the industry right down and enforced GMP, good manufacturing procedures. Many probiotic supplements that were sold up until not that long ago, up to 50% of them were basically not really probiotics. They were just milk powder or just crap that people were selling. And then there was a big shakedown in the American dietary supplement business, which changed all that. Okay. So now we know that a lot of probiotics are credible, but some operators don't really still sell high-quality products. They're not telling us in the studies what strains were used, what probiotics were used, how people took them, what diets that these people were on. They could have been drinking Coca-Cola, swallowing probiotics with a Budweiser beer for all we know. I mean, we don't know any of this kind of stuff. So studies can prove anything you want. I could prove a study right now and argue any kind of point with you and probably win because I made the study make it look like that. So millions of people around the world benefit from probiotics on a daily basis. But we're always going to get science to give us a dig in the side It's funny how they never mention any bad things about antibiotics and about the resistance with bad bacteria. But there's a lot of finger pointing now at the probiotic market. And that's because the probiotic market has taken off. It's a $1 billion industry, like it rightly should be. It should be a powerful industry. Pro means for, you know, anti means against. Doesn't it make more sense in your head to think that we should be looking at pro rather than anti when it comes to medicine? Medicine's built on the premise everything is anti. Kill, get rid of, destroy. Whereas natural medicine's built on the pro basis, you know, build, encourage, proliferate. So, and we're always going to get these two sides clashing. So, but you do your own homework, and you, when you start reading these studies, you realize there's a lot of BS when it comes to these reports. It also says, however, the studies did not look at the clinical effects of probiotics, and more research remains to be done. Well, mate, a lot of research has been done with the clinical effects. I could show you guys 100 links now to credible studies right now that point to the power of probiotics when properly administered, the proper strains, you're going to get a very powerful effect. Let's look at the two well-known lactobacillus strains, lactobacillus plantarum, lactobacillus rhamnosus, and also lactobacillus acidophilus, DDS1. Now, these three strains have been very heavily studied now for a long time. There are thousands of scientific studies that validate those three particular probiotics I've just mentioned there. Dr. Kem Shahani worked for nearly 30 years on lactobacillus DDS1. This is a human strain of a beneficial bacteria, and it's proven. Kem conducted over 250, or wrote over 250 papers supporting the use of this particular lactobacillus. If you look at plantarum and rhamnosus, it's the same thing. There are hundreds of studies that support its use with people, you know, around antibiotic use. So, but you're always going to read these kinds of reports that will kind of negate everything. It is important to bear in mind that some people we see do react quite strongly to probiotics. They get very sick. So remember, look at my video regarding the D and the L lactate forms of probiotics as well. There are many reasons why people feel sick when they take probiotics too. They take too much, they take them at the wrong time, they take the wrong strain, they don't have the right diet to support probiotics. These are all important considerations. That's why it's important to see somebody who understands how to use probiotics properly and incorporate them into your lifestyle, along with other recommendations like the correct ways to eat. You may need enzymes to support the probiotics as well. You know, these are all important considerations, and none of this is taken into account with the study that I just showed you. So this to me is just another study that goes on the scrap heap, but it does show people that you need to be cautious with probiotic use. But in my opinion, it does not negate the use of probiotics whatsoever, and it's certainly not dangerous supplements to take. You know, these guys want to look at their own messes that they create before they start pointing the finger at probiotics, because antibiotics account for so much death and disease and morbidity in the world. One day it will all come out, all this absolute mess and disgrace, one day. And hopefully this video will be up long enough for people to say, wow, look, he's right. Antibiotics were the worst thing that were ever created. We need to find a solution, folks, for this antibiotic mess, because you know, we're getting more and more problems with the, you know, resistance with many bacteria now. So we need to look at alternate methods. Who knows? Maybe that they might even go back one day into grapefruit seed extract if they can patent it or make enough money out of it. Big Pharma will use cow's urine or whatever they can to make money. But yeah, you do your own reading and have a good look at these reports online about probiotics and make up your own mind. But I'd be careful about who I believe in when it comes to, you know, strong statements about things not really working. Make up your own mind. Thanks for tuning in.